Okay, we're back with part two. Grand Theft Auto Vice City. Story continues. Should be able to do two videos and all back to back this time. Grand Theft Auto game, we're going to see San Andreas. There's tons of extra features in it you do. In this game we see I can get something to eat and fills up my health. We're going to see a lot more of that in San Andreas. It's like kind of a bigger part of the story. You can also gain weight in that game. You can work out, turn your fat into muscle. Got a meter, it shows your body fat and your muscle and all that good stuff. Okay, let's do my armor. Flashing yellow lights. I've never seen that before.
Now stay away from me.
Someone runs into me, I usually chase them down and shoot at them. That will happen in San Andreas when I hit other people. Sometimes I'll get out of their vehicle and attack me. It's kind of funny.
Knows what I'm saying. Tommy, any progress? No. Tell me later. Tommy, this is Avery Carrington. I believe you met at the party.
Not in person.
Howdy. Avery here has a proposition.
Other things on our mind.
I'm trying to keep the wolves from the door. So could you please cut me some slack? I'm stretched like a wire, and even if I'm dead by the end of the week, I'd like to think that I didn't die poor.
Now just calm down, both of you. Son, you help me, and any greaseballs giving you a hard time, I'll see to it they take a long dirt nap.
Okay, what could I do for you?
This delivery company's got its depot on some fine land. They won't sell. They're hanging on like a big old prairie rat. We gotta go in there and smoke that vermin out. Head on down there and set up a hornet's nest. Security will have their hands full, and then you can sneak in and put them out of business.
And you could drop by Raphael's for a change of clothes. You might be there a while, but yeah, go for it.
Should be a riot.
The balls drop like they should. Stop by my office sometime.
Did you notice before I went in there, I was wearing my blue coat that I got at Raphael's. Once I got in there, I was back to my old blue shirt. Okay, the music's a little loud. I'm Okay, so now I can go to Ortez's place.
Hey, you want to beat me?
Okay, they got blocked. Knock people over with a water cannon, which is pretty funny. Use the cheats anyway.
Come in and park yourself on the hide, son. Hell, my daddy used to say never look a gift horse in the mouth. Well, by golly, he never did.
Would you like a
no, thanks.
A clean thinker. I like that. Now, the property business isn't all about highfalutin paper pushing. It's about dirt and the will to claim that dirt. You with me, son?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I need some tenacious bastard to let go of some dirt. And you look to me like the kind of guy to persuade him.
Persuasion's my forte.
Yeah, he'll be down at the country club, down on the golf course. They don't allow guns, so his bodyguards won't be packing lawgivers. Go beat 8 tons of crap out of him. Here now, I got you a membership. And boy, you're gonna need more appropriate clothes.
I'm gonna get some golfer clothes.
Is this me?
My size, baby.
Heavy on the food.
Okay,
you know what I mean, man?
Play.
These people are wrong kind, man.
Okay, so I gotta kill that guy up there. Guy in the white shirt. But I lose all my weapons when I walk through the metal detector. Can't take them in with me. So now you can either attack the guy and he takes off running and chase him all around the golf course and it's really hard to catch him. Or you can use the cheat code, the weapons cheat. Never got my weapons back. Go to your sniper rifle. Better get a better angle. Aim it on him. See, this is so touchy. Usually takes 2 shots for some reason. Watch out for the water while driving. See, they said that they don't allow guns at the golf course. It's funny, I can walk around with a gun and they don't say anything or do anything. Once I leave the metal detector, I can pick up all my old weapons. Oh, my vehicle's gone. There's a change of clothes right there. A bunch of scuff clothing. So, if you have it, like it says right there, 1-star or 2-star one level, it'll be cleared.
So I scoured the club from top to bottom, and then I find this snooty little
take him over to his honey bread and make them think. I make them talk and tell them some jokes. And soon they are singing and they are dancing. And I think, Fernando, do you have a gift for them? A gift for them, yes. I like to see men and women get together. People say, Fernando, choose your gift to make me buy a job or maybe a best car. And I say, Fernando is on the field. Listen to some commercials and stuff. Don't go away. Do bring the number. Do
take both hands off the wheel and touch the steering. Do you feel the power? Ah, oh, yes, friend. It has a lot of power. But there is old school. And I have been sent to shine a light on all degenerates, philanderers, liberals, and other evildoers, and expose them for what they really are.
I'm going to take one of those cop cars to do the phone mission. If you walk into the police station, you get a wanted level, so it's something you might not want to do. Sometimes this mission is kind of tough. But...
Mr. Steele, you have been eradicating those out-of-towners for invaluable business. I have more work for you with a more hands-on approach. Your next job is taped under the phone.
So I gotta chase this pizza boy down. He's on a moped. I gotta shoot him down. Okay, now tell me how he didn't fall off his bike. Shot at him. Imagine that a cop car is going to drive the same path as him. Yeah, I'm going to fail this mission. Thank you. gods, look at that. Turn my sirens on or off because the red light's flashing. I can't tell if my car is up in flames or not. And I know my car's taking quite a beating. Look at that. All those bullets missed him. See, that's just totally fake. And what is he, James Bond? Yeah, forget it. I quit. I'm dead. So we won't be seeing that mission again. Okay, how's he delivering, making all those deliveries? I didn't see him delivering, I just seen him keep driving. So I'm going to go to Colonel Cortez's mission as soon as I get out of these golfer clothes. Find a bike down here. That's always nice that when some of the missions you fail turn out to be the ones you don't have to beat. Continue on with the story. Who knows, I might try to do that mission again later on in the videos. I get towards the end.
Mr. Versetti,
Colonel.
Thank you for coming. Please see.
A lobster?
No, thanks.
I am ashamed to admit that one of the causes of our mutual problem appears to have been the loose tongue of a man I used to trust. I've been carrying Gonzalez for years, but now his incompetence reaches new heights. It's only right that you did Gonzalez.
Did he do it? It's the money that's important to me.
For this kindness, I'll reward you. And then we will find your money together. We will be at his penthouse, half drunk, probably. Who's this?
See, they're trying to make it like Scarface, Al Pacino. You're down in, like, Miami-type area, and you're supposed to kill a guy with a chainsaw. I mean, why use a chainsaw when you got all these other weapons. Either it's hard to run with that thing. See, if you're just use a gun.
Wow! It's flesh of them! I like it! Huge and flesh! Flesh, flesh. It's flesh of them!
The key to feeling great is looking great, and the way to look great is to have great hands. That's great.
Hey, idiot. That's not the vehicle I wanted.
Stop being such an
idiot. See, the main purpose of this mission is to give me a wanted level. Teach me how to use the pain spray, in case we haven't played the previous game. Everywhere in this game too, like every single block. There we go. We need to find a vehicle. That staff that I can get into. find the ugliest one. It's always free the first time when it's a training mission. Your one level has been suspended. If you commit a crime whilst the stars are flashing, your full one level will be restored.
Right.
And there's the safe house I'm going to be buying when I get $6,000. Right up here. See, it's got a garage right there too. This old car instead.
But not as interesting as what happens when a man and a woman fall passionately in love. Or maybe things go wrong when you meet a man like Fernando to sort things out, to make things whole and better again. When you're throwing household dishes at each other, when she pulls out the knife. Now I'm in the crotch, but not in the mind, you know?
Your prescription for all the emotions. Emotion.
Jump. Yeah, it's not easy to steer when you're taking a drink of coffee. Car park right in front. Go ahead and change my clothes and save my game. Just change your clothes and just go up to your room. Just run away. Back to my normal clothes. Nice hotel, huh? No door, it's wide open. Anyone can walk in. Okay, let's go to Avery Carrington again. As you may have noticed, the cars can take much more of a beating in this game than they can in the last game. But Revolution, I think it is. This one's pretty fun. Yes, it is.
Now look here, son. I got a problem, and I reckon you could help me.
I'm no builder.
No, I was thinking more of your demolition skills. Now this here, this is a development as planned, and this is the property that we're looking at.
You're trying to say this new office block is kind of in the way.
You catch on quick. Now I'm gonna head out of town for a while, and if that office development were to face sudden and insurmountable structural problems, then I...
As a civil-minded individual, you feel obliged to step in and save the rejuvenation of an important area of the city.
Where can I get more guys like you?
Four bombs I gotta pick up, place them on targets, these big canisters. On each floor of the building. I also got these guys attacking me. Got these construction workers. And for some odd reason, they've got an armed security guard inside of a building. That guy right there. Might be more than one. I don't know why they need an armed guard inside of a building with that construction workers working in it. Pick up one of these bombs. Use the L2 and R2 buttons to steer. Press the X button to go up. Square button to go down. I like to start on the top floor and work my way down.
What the?
Yeah, just get close to them, head the front of your helicopter towards them guys. And you'll cut them with your blades. Now the guys with the hammers, they can't really do much if...
Damn, I gotta lay off the pills. I'm seeing shit.
Yeah, the guys with the hammers, if they're not near you, they really can't hurt you. All they can do is swing their hammers at you. The guys with the guns, they'll like to shoot at you, so you might want to take care of them right away. Okay, I'm on the top floor. And there's another security guard. Now, the square is my target. Triangle's pressing down. Those indicate targets below me.
Cross kill the mallets.
Just go back, get another bomb. Keep on doing it. So go up to the, not the top, top four, but the second from the top. See, those triangles represent, if they're pointing up, that means the target is above my location. Down, cursor down. Square means they're at the same location as me. In this game, there's like a streak behind him, like a smoke streak. It's almost like a Matrix. Fool. Speaking of the Matrix, it's another game we're going to see on the PS2 called Enter the Matrix. I don't plan on playing too far into that game. Probably be one video. Games 2003. Most of my games are pretty spread out. We have one game from 2001. This is the only game from 2002. I think we got maybe like three games from 2003. Like two games from 2004. In 2005, we only got one game. If I could see. You know what? This guy is really annoying me. You gotta be kidding me. My blades aren't chopping him. Okay. They're cheating, so I'm getting out of here. Oh my god. I've never done this bad in my life. Got smoke coming on me, my timer's getting low. I don't think I've ever failed this mission in my life. And I might just fail it this time because my timer is really getting down there. Idiot. Usually I beat this mission with like a minute or two left. That was the last second of victory. That was like a James Bond victory. Fire truck tipped on its side. trying to push it to see if I could tip it back up, right side up. Trigger this mission and you send off on your way. Sometimes I've had a bad habit of turning to the left or right away and walking right off the edge of this. I think it's usually to the left. I'm walking right over the edge, fall in the water and die.
Tommy, come, join me. This looks delicious, huh? Happy as snuff.
No.
Tommy, you are like a pompous breeze that has freed me from the stench of corruption. Although I must appear to mourn his passing and carry on with business as usual.
This isn't getting me any closer to my money.
Tommy, my friend, I'm not in liberty now. Here, we do things differently. I will continue with my inquiries, but in the meantime,
Cortez.
You're a good friend, Tommy. I knew you would not let me down. I need you to meet the crew. Because I need some value of the crew.
Okay, so meet the courier at the mall. I want to get a faster car than this. Oh, here we go. This way. You want to chase him when he runs. Once again, you're going to get a one level after this mission. Or not after the mission, but on the mission. Now, you don't want to shoot that guy. I tried that once. I thought, because I wasn't sure about this mission, I thought I was supposed to kill him, so I thought, well, I'll do it before. But no, you want to talk to him first.
What?
Come on. Look, Cortez sent me. Just give me the damn chips.
Oh, please appear this American pig that is propriétaire de la gouvernement français. Hand it over, you American idiot. They followed you here. Feed him for the police.
didn't want to risk getting back in the car because there were too many cops around, and I don't know if they're on foot close by. I don't want to risk them busting me as I'm getting in the car.
There's nothing more natural than this enormous bush-like fur growing under each arm. Having hair is natural. What's the deal with Andrew's absence? I mean, what happened? The hair and hair don't shave their underarms. It's really quite attractive. You just need to focus your eyes to work the healthy signs and not the signs of socialized barbarism, like shaving or wearing deodorant or birthing in the hospital, rather than the open air like a wolf cub. Remember how the loneliness and the loneliness?
I find this really interesting.
Not really, but I say this because I'm going to.
I'll be back on K-Chat after these messages from our sponsors.
It's 4:30 in the morning here. Farewell, Ranch. It's time to get up and work the old cow. Get up, you're up! Farewell, Ranch. Old people don't sit around stagnating, watching game shows and talking about the good old days. Sinking into the grave in a urine-soaked mess.
PCJ600 here. Go back to the hotel, save my game.
We are here to press the issue. My city is in trouble, and I think we are not really providing any serious solution. So far, we've got secession rearing its ugly head for the first time in centuries. We've got to ignore it, and we've got to give everyone a flower. You know that a little unrealistic, yes? Not to say over-opinionated and moronic, but Mr. Grayshaw, how do we stop people running amok in the city with machine guns and heavy artillery?
We've got to give a man a chance. Prisons are overflowing with wasted potential. Make the guilty men innocent once more. Free them from themselves.
How? How on earth do you do that?
Well, you could let them off.
Harvest. Great. That's a sensible plan.
Then they wouldn't be guilty anymore.
We've been doing that for years, you idiot. How do you think we'd keep prison costs down? It ain't by magic or cooking the books. We save that for education. But, as in most things, we in government are saving money so that you don't have to. When we spend less money on services, more goes to administration salaries and expenses, which helps make lives a lot less difficult for everybody. It's about sharing. Sharing your taxes out amongst a select few. That's why I worked so hard at school, so I could reap the rewards now.
To work hard at school because the other kids laughed at you and called you a square.
That's a damn lie.
They call me Red Bar. They call me the Bat because my voice didn't break until I was 19.
Well, Mr. Shrub, I take it you don't believe in regulation.
I believe in giving people a chance, not tying them down with lots of needless regulations. The fact is, business is run by moral people who won't do anything illegal or try to get rich quickly.
Okay, so we're going to save my game, and I'm going to end the video and move on to part 3. So, I'm going to go ahead and end the video right here. And we'll be back in part 3. We still got like 4 minutes, but oh well, it's close enough to the end where we can go ahead and do it.